Hello, you beautiful people of the internet. Welcome back to another episode. My name is John Huynh, and welcome back to another slice of my life. As you can see, we're back at Disneyland for 2024 spooky season. It is full gear Halloween mode in September of 2024. Now, they've already been starting since August of 2024, and we're kind of in the middle of the Halloween season, and I'm here to check out some new eats, new decorations, and check out some different things that I wasn't able to check out last year. This is my only second time at Disneyland for Halloween season, so there is so much more to see, and I want to share it with you guys. And yeah, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the journey with me. I'll see you guys soon. What's up, everybody? Today is Thursday, September 19th, 2024. I just made it back home to Southern California this morning at around 3 a.m. It is currently now about 7 a.m. I haven't slept a wink all night because Alan was snoring, so I couldn't really sleep. And I think I drank the Monster earlier in the morning around 12, so that kind of helped me not sleep. But you know what, Disneyland 1 hour, I'll see if I can survive. As you can see, I have my Winnie the Pooh bear shirt on. I'm going with Winnie the Pooh today. Got my, of course, Magic Band Plus. Got my backpack decked out. Mickey and Minnie are in their kind of semi-Halloween costume. Minnie is in her Halloween costume, but Mickey doesn't have one. So he's just wearing the Disneyland Spirit jersey. Then of course we got the usual bells and whistles. I got a bunch of filming equipment in here, of course. And then I also brought with me my 100 year anniversary Spirit jersey. For those of you guys who don't know what that looks like, it is this stunning black with this purple puff print right there, and also glitters, so it's cool. I don't know how I'm gonna wear this, because obviously during the daytime it's probably still pretty warm, so I don't know, we'll see. And then of course I'm rocking the white Disneyland resort hat, and I'm gonna pair that with the 100 year anniversary silver ears. So yeah, anyways, I'll see you guys in a bit. Probably get some coffee and then drive straight to Mickey and Friends parking lot, find a parking, get on the tram, do security, and then we'll see happens at rope drop. So see you guys in a bit.
After a sleepless night, we're finally at the parks. I parked around 8:05 in the morning. We had just barely missed rope drop, and then we're taking the tram into the parks itself. And as soon as I got there, nostalgia hit me right away, seeing the characters with their pumpkin heads, seeing the park completely transformed into Halloween spooky season in September. Was just mesmerizing. The pop of oranges and reds and yellows, and it just brought back so much fun memories. I just love seeing Halloween decorations up, and Main Street was beautiful. But we go ahead and start our morning by getting some coffee and cookies, so go ahead and join me as we talk about the cookies.
What's up, everyone? Welcome back. We're at Disneyland Halloween 2024. If you remember from last year, we got the Mickey Bat cookie, and we got it again. And you can get this at the Starbucks on Main Street. Now, I really like eating this cookie last year. I don't know if it's still the same. It looks exactly the same. Let's give it a shot and see if it still tastes the same. It still tastes exactly the same. Really good cookie. This was $6.50, right? $6.50, pretty worth it. So if you're ever at Starbucks,
Make sure you grab a cookie as well. All right, guys, on to the next one.
And you want some pumpkins?
Pumpkins.
See how well I draw pumpkins today. I unfortunately have a tremble in my hand.
Oh no, that's fine. I think that will add character.
All right, your pumpkin is a little bit.
That's fine.
There's one pumpkin right there.
Okay.
One right there.
Oh,
perfect.
I think it looks cute.
Thank you.
We randomly ran into Goofy out in the streets here at Main Street. He's wearing like this scarecrow outfit.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. So we're starting off pretty strong because we're going to be focusing on food today. You know, we're pretty hungry. We just got in town last night. So the first stop we're going to make is Pizza Planet. And I just love the interior design. Love these cute little green men. Alright, what's up everyone? We're back at Pizza Planet and we're checking out this Alien Buzz Macaron. It is filled with cream and berries. Check that out in the center. And it's already quite fragile, it's already crumbling. I'm gonna go ahead and split it open in half and see if you guys can get that. Yeah, let's go ahead and try it. Oh yeah. This is a bit on the sweeter side. The berry is a very prominent flavor in this. Very good though. When I came to the order window, they picked this out of the refrigerator, so it has a little bit of coldness to it. So today's a little bit humid at Disneyland. So being inside here in the air conditioner and taking a bite of this cold macaron, this is what it's all about. Well, anyways, I'm gonna finish this and I'll see you guys at the next location. All right. All right, what's up everyone? We're back at Jolly Holiday. We're checking out two of my favorite food items here at Disneyland. Last time I had this was last year and we're finally back. I've been thinking about these two sandwiches since last year. We're gonna start off first with the classic Jolly Holiday combo, which is pretty much a grilled cheese sandwich right here. Check that out. Oh, look at that. Ooey gooey cheese. Take a little dip. There. Oh man. That's exactly how I remembered it. The tomato basil soup is not as chunky as last year, but I don't really mind it personally. I like it the way it is right now, just because I think it clings to the cheese a lot more, or the grilled cheese a lot more. And it's just still as creamy as I remember. Next up, we have the Boogulgi cheese toast sandwich. Check this out. So this has bulgogi, of course, kimchi aioli, and some cheese in there. And of course it is accompanied by the corn chowder. So, so good. Let's go ahead and give it a little dunk. And it's still nice and hot too. Oh yeah, that's also just like I remembered it. There's just something that's sweet and rich and creamy about that corn chowder. I don't even know how they make it like that. It's just so good. But I'm telling you guys, if you guys are here for Disneyland for Halloween, you guys gotta get both of these. Like, two of the best things I've ever eaten, especially this Boogulgi grilled cheese sandwich with the corn chowder. The prices did go up this year a little bit, but you know what? It is worth every single penny.
So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy the rest of this. I'll see you guys later. Alright, what's up everyone? We're here at the Jolly Holiday. We're checking out some of their Halloween seasonal items here. We got the apple caramel cheesecake right here. I love the design, the little bat chocolate. So cute. Can't wait to taste that a little bit later. And then additionally, we also picked up the jack-o'-lantern Mickey pumpkin Macaron. Check that out. So we had a Macaron earlier from Pizza Planet. It was the Alien Buzz Macaron, and it was a bit too sweet. Also, it was very fragile. This one has a little bit more, what do you call it? This one's a bit more dense, so it's not crumbling on us, so which is good. I'm surprised. I'm also excited to try this too. It's got a little Mickey ears. So yeah, stay tuned.
It's always a fun time over here at Candy Palace. I love coming here to looking through the exhibition windows, seeing their cast members make candy. It's such a fun experience, and there's usually not a lot of people here, so you can go ahead and stand over here and get pretty good front row seats. And it looks like they're kind of making some bars. I think it's toffee bars with almonds or peanuts. I'm not 100% sure. I did not check what they were making. It's probably some kind of rocky road or something like that. But yeah, always a fun time.
Thank you.
taxi's crazy, what the heck?
Hurry, hurry, hurry! Step right up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls!
Let's go! There they are! Yeah! Busy right there!
What's up, everyone? We're here in Frontierland checking out Rancho del Zocalo Restaurante. It is a Mexican restaurant, and we have a couple of different things to show today. First thing that I want to show you is my Cubana torta. So check this out. It's a massive sandwich. I did watch a couple YouTube videos before coming, and some of the YouTubers were complaining that it was only half a sandwich, and in the video it did look like one of these halves, but looks like to me we're getting a full sandwich now. So I don't know if they got a lot of complaints, so maybe Disney was like, maybe we should give them a full sandwich. So this looks really good. So it comes with a breaded steak, looks like ham, and then turkey in there, and there's some avocado as well as lettuce and tomatoes. So it looks like a pretty good mix of healthy and unhealthy stuff. Of course, comes with chips as well. The second thing I ordered is an esquite bowl, which is pretty much corn that is cut off the cob, as you can see here. And it came with some chips as well, so I'm excited to try that. I love a good elote, so without the cob, it's a lot less work. So I'm excited to try some of this. And then my dear friend Alan got the asada fries, and I was thinking that would come with normal fries, but it actually comes with these film strip fries, pretty much like a thick version of a curly fries, and he said it was a little bit spicy, so I'm curious, so I want to give it a one shot here. So let me get some of that avocado. Oh yeah, he wasn't kidding. It does have a little bit of kick to it, but yeah, I'm excited to try the Cubana, and I'm gonna come back and tell you guys how it is soon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've been waiting for. I'm gonna go in for this bite of this torta right here. So excited. Oh yeah. So the breaded beef still has a bit of a crunch to it. Very good. It has a very nice bite to it. The beans at the bottom has a bit of a kick to it. And all of the vegetables gives it a lot of depth and texture. Very good. And I didn't realize that that wasn't turkey. That's actually cheese in the middle. So I found something out. All right. Yeah, very good Cubana sandwich. All right, everyone. Last but not least, we got the esquite bowl. So like I said earlier, this is a elote, but without the cob. So they've already taken all the corn kernels and put it into a bowl. Tradition is just eaten in a cup with a spoon. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. They did give us some tortilla chips, but I'm gonna use a spoon. Get a nice little scoop with all the fixings on the top right here. It's got little seasonings, got a little nice creamy stuff. Oh, right here. Oh. All right. So there's a crunchy element to this bowl of esquite that I was not expecting. It's almost like they crushed up the corn chips. I forgot what it's called, but it is crispy on the top, and it's got a little bit of a kick to it. Not overly rich and creamy, which I believe a lot of people will appreciate because sometimes too much mayo is involved, but this is delicious. You guys should try this esquite bowl if you guys ever come to Zocalo. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy this because this is too good not to eat.
After we finished eating at Rancho del Zocalo, it kind of went downhill from there. We were extremely tired and sleep deprived, so we stopped by Downtown Disney to kind of slow our roll. But by the time we got back to the park, it was already nighttime. So as we're entering back into the park, it was extremely busy. But as you can see, this is where the magic really begins for Main Street, especially with all the Halloween decorations. Coming back to the park, it was super busy. A lot of people had just gone off work, so now they're here to kind of enjoy being at Disneyland. So yeah, me and Alan are just kind of walking around getting some last minute b-roll shots, and we're actually on our way home. I think this was about 8:30, 9 o'clock. We had just kept asking each other what we want to do next, and I was a zombie at this point, so we decided to go home. So yeah, just getting some last minute reroll shots before I head home.
Hi.
Hello, just me.
Perfect.
Hi, Minnie. Look who I brought for you.
How cute.
Your favorite. Yes. You look so stunning. I love your new outfit this year. I love the extra colors. You look beautiful. Oh, let's take a picture. Yes.
Okay, perfect. One, two, and three. Stay right there. One, two, three, and gotcha. Good job.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Really love your outfit this year. Can't wait to see what you have for next year. Yes. Bye bye. Oh, yes. Thank you. Hi, Mickey. I really like your bow tie. You look so dapper this year. And guess who I brought to meet you?
Is that Minnie?
That is Minnie. It is. And she has her own costume. And she told me to give you a message.
Can you relay that back?
Can we get a picture?
Big smile.
Perfect.
Thank you so much. I can't wait to see what you have installed for next year. Your costume's getting better every year, and I love it. Thank you so much.
Just going up this way?
Yep.
Awesome.
Thank you. Bye bye.